In the first instance, I think it would be very proper to mention the importance of this road to the people of these axis. What I mean is that Ebonyi State is made up of Ebonyi South, Central, and North. And this is Ebonyi South. So this is the only road that links the people from South to the state capital. And so it's very, very important. Most of them, before now, had to reside at Abakeleke, and you know the cost of living. But today, the road is on construction, ongoing. People can comfortably move from Afikpo to their place of work and come back easily. So it was a very, very, very deplorable position then. But now, I think 45 minutes, 50 minutes, 60 minutes, you are there at the state capital. So it has brought a lot of relief economically, politically, socially and otherwise to the people from the South.
What was it that socially is done in this state?
Of course, you can see business activities, some recreation parks are here and there, centers. It wasn't because of the bad road. People can comfortably move from a back lake down here to enjoy themselves with some, you know, social recreation centers because of this road. And from TV, they want to get to go back to the back lake. And the political aspect of it is that people, when there's political activity at the state level, can equally comfortably move. I think even the governor, through the campaign now, is an easy movement. They can go into the areas and do their campaign because of the guru.
And was it possible?
It wasn't at all. But right now, absolutely yes. Because before now, there were so many people who never knew even what was called excavator, dozer, and the rest of them. But because of the presence of the construction company as a result of this project going, so many people can even operate such machines. And they are paid. So many of them can even drive big trucks. They are paid because of this project. So the youth are benefiting. I can tell you that even right now, a lot of them have been absorbed by Julius Vega. That's a neighboring construction company here, trained by the CCC. Also of this project and elsewhere, they are now employable beyond CCCC.
Yes.
Yes, but mostly some of them are undeveloped. There's one, is a copper that served in this community that located it. They call it Okumebi. The state government is aware. Through the Minister of Culture and Tourism, but yet undeveloped. We have beach, what we call a Bara beach. Some festive period like Easter, Christmas, people go there and do that. But it's undeveloped. But with this route, and probably the federal government can extend the injection, I think that would be very good. And then we have a lot of questions.
The community has a lot of
I can
also help the tourism.
I think I'm a living witness. My family are there at the back lake. I see them almost on a daily basis because the road is good now. So likewise others. People from Africa are coming down to stay here.